the Schluter Wi-Fi Thermostat makes it easier than ever to control, monitor, or program your DITRA-HEAT floor warming system anytime from anywhere, from your tablet, smartphone, or computer. In this video, we will walk you through how to set up your thermostat, connecting the device to Wi-Fi, and setting up and using your online account to control the thermostat remotely. All of the steps to set up and use the thermostat are covered in detail in the user manual found online. At this point, your thermostat should be installed and connected to the heating cables and floor temperature sensors, as shown in the DITRA-HEAT installation handbooks and videos. Let's get started. When the thermostat is installed and turned on for the first time, or after a factory reset, the system will run a startup wizard. First, choose your preferred language. Confirm the power supplied voltage from your electrical panel matches the voltage rating of your heating cable. If it does not, or you are unsure, contact your installation professional. Next, the system will conduct a self-test. Press the button on top of the thermostat to test the GFCI safety feature. The test is successful if the red light in the test button lights up and a ground fault error text is shown on the display. Press the power reset button on the lower right side of the thermostat to reset the GFCI. Then tap the arrow right button to continue. Next, set your temperature unit, Fahrenheit or Celsius. The next screen is the load measurement power meter. This automatically detects the wattage power consumption of the heating cable. In most cases, we recommend keeping it on. If your installation includes one or more power modules, turn the load measurement to off. Calculate the total wattage yourself and set the floor's power load manually. Keep the default 10 kiloohms for the temperature sensors supplied with the Schluter thermostat. Set and format the date. Select and format the time. Once we connect to Wi-Fi, we will be able to synchronize with server to obtain the time from the internet. Finally, set the floor protection. It's best to keep the default here. The tile maximum temperature is 104 degrees Fahrenheit or 40 degrees Celsius. That's it. You're done with Setup Wizard First Startup. Tap the screen to activate the thermostat. Let's check out some of the other features. These are covered in detail in the user manual available online. You can customize your floor warming manually by programming your own custom schedules, or you can also choose from a preset schedule option. The information screen can give you an overview of the thermostat specifications and setup. There is also a QR code to view this information on your phone. You can track your energy costs by entering your local electricity billing rate in cents per kilowatt hour. The installer settings include the adaptive function. This means that the thermostat has the ability to recognize the program schedule and will adapt accordingly. It learns from warm-up times to improve its program precision. The open window option shuts off the heat temporarily in response to a sudden drop in temperature. User settings includes child lock, which prevents tampering with the thermostat. The thermostat can be unlocked with an L-shaped swipe on the touchscreen. Finally, user reset can be used for a change of ownership. Now, let's look at connecting the thermostat to Wi-Fi. This is just like getting any other device onto your Wi-Fi network. First, tap the menu button in the top right of the thermostat screen. Select the Wi-Fi weather button. Here, you'll see a list of all the Wi-Fi networks available to the thermostat. If you can't see your network, maybe the signal is too weak where the thermostat is. Select your Wi-Fi network and enter the corresponding Wi-Fi password. The thermostat will attempt to connect to your Wi-Fi network. Like any Wi-Fi device, you will need sufficient signal strength from your router, the correct password, and permission to use the Wi-Fi network you are trying to connect to. If it is unable to connect, please consult the Thermostat User Manual Troubleshooting section for guidance. Usually, it will connect in a few seconds. Enter a name for the thermostat, such as the room to be controlled, or similar, such as bathroom 1 or kitchen. Enter your email address for your account setup. If this is your first registration, you'll receive an activation email. You'll have to activate your account through another device, like your phone, tablet, or computer. The thermostat will connect to the account server and register automatically once you have activated your account. Next, enter your zip code or postal code. This sets the location for your weather forecast. That completes the Wi-Fi setup. The Wi-Fi icon shows an active connection. The weather icon indicates that the thermostat is getting forecasts from the internet server. Now let's look at managing thermostats via the website using either a computer or a mobile device. The first time you set up a Schluter-Systems Wi-Fi thermostat, an activation email will be sent to the email address you provided during first startup. Click on the activation link and enter your details for online registration. Choose a password and a security question. You'll be automatically logged in to the DITRA-HEAT website. You should see on screen your newly registered thermostat with the name you gave it. This would be a good time to bookmark the website. Now that your account has been created, you can log in to the website at DITRA-HEAT-E-WiFi.schluter.com on your mobile device or computer, at home or elsewhere. If you want to add another thermostat, simply repeat the same steps you took to register the first one. You will receive an activation email for each thermostat you register and will need to repeat the process each time. When you log in, you will see images of all your registered thermostats with the names you assigned them. Now let's take a look at how you can communicate online with your thermostats. If you hover the mouse over the thermostat, a menu icon will appear at the bottom right. Click on it, and 6 program options will appear. From here, you can choose to pre-program your floor temperature for each day of the week. Let's choose Monday. You set the temperature at 82 degrees for 7 a.m. for when you get up. Next, you lower the temperature at 8:30 to 70 degrees for when you leave for work. Make sure to activate the event. Then, you raise the temperature for when you get home, and lower it for bedtime. Click on the bottom right check mark to save your changes. To copy this schedule to other days of the week, simply hit the plus button at the bottom of the screen. Then select the other days you wish to copy to, and then press the check mark. If you have more than one residence, you can also group your thermostats. To create a group, click on the pen icon on the upper right of the screen. Then, click on the plus. An empty box will appear just below the thermostats. Enter a group name and click on the check mark to save your changes. Assign your thermostats to this group by choosing the group name in the drop-down menu. Repeat this process for any other thermostats you would like saved to a group. You're able to change the names of your thermostats and locations and regroup them at any time. Tracking energy use can be done by simply choosing the thermostat from the drop-down menu. You can track energy use by day, week, or year. At any time, you are also able to adjust your account settings or preferences, including adjusting the time format, temperature unit, or username and password information. After setting up the thermostat and completing the email registration, you can download an app for your mobile device to manage your thermostat. The app allows remote control of core functions. Support is available online and by phone from Schluter-Systems. Enjoy the comfort and convenience of your new Wi-Fi-enabled floor-warming thermostat.